This is the IB5ATB chain drive differential, the version with the twin disc rotors. These are 240 by 5 mm thick disc rotors. It's on a pivot mounting carrier. This mounting carrier has mounts for a pair of Honda CBR 900 RR Fireblade calipers, front calipers, the four pot ones. And they would mount on here. The pivot carrier is designed that the bolts at the top and bottom, one there and one there, would normally be mounted at right angles to a line between the centre of this sprocket and the sprocket on the gearbox of the bike engine. And that will give you a maximum range of pivoting if you pivot it on the bottom mount. There is an additional, I'll just take this off for the minute, there's an additional bolt here which can also run in a quadrant. So when you pivot it, this is a fixed pivot point. Will be a quadrant with a slot going in this direction, and up here a quadrant with a slot going in that direction, and then you can get the necessary chain adjustment. This one has stub shafts with flanges on that take 100 mm Lobro bolt-on CV joints. These three bolts are just in here to hold on, because the disc bell is normally held onto the output shaft by the six bolts that hold the CV joint on. The disc itself bolts onto this aluminium alloy disc bell that in turn bolts onto the stub axle. The titanium bolts that mount this disc on are threaded into the aluminium disc bell. There's a steel insert in the disc bell itself, and then these self-locking metal self-locking nuts are just additional locking to stop the bolts backing out. There's minimal clearance between one of the legs of the caliper mount to the disc bell, hence this relief cut just in here. In fact, the lock nuts have been machined down in one face to clear as well. Just everything's a bit tight in there. These stub shafts, I've got the splines here that go into the differential. There is a retaining clip that goes onto that groove just here. You only want to fit that retaining clip the final time you fit the stub shafts into the chain drive differential, once you've got it all installed in your chassis. Otherwise you have trouble getting these back off. To get them back out, you've usually got to put a slide hammer onto the stub shaft and give it a sharp tap to break the wire clip free. It will compress against the inner splines there, and it will slide out, but it sometimes needs a good tap to get it out. Once you've got one out, you can put a slender steel rod through the centre. There's a hole all the way through, and you can knock out the opposing one again with a sharp tap. The journal there, that 28 mm journal, just runs on the inside of the differential itself. It doesn't give a lot of support, and as we're using a disc brake on here, we've added an additional roller bearing. There's a very slim roller bearing mounted where we would normally fit an oil seal. It rides on the oil seal journal here. When installing this for the final time, if you put a smear of RTV gasket material on the inside of the bearing and on the journal face, that should give you a good seal onto the inner ring and stop any of the grease coming back through that pathway. The bearing itself has a seal on it. It's a double sealed rubber sealed bearing, so there shouldn't be any grease coming out of that. But the possibility it could come through the inner race, and between the inner race and the journal on there. So a little bit of RTV should seal that. Not too much that it clogs the bearing up. Again, when installing this, if you apply plenty of grease inside the splined area inside the differential itself, and between this outer bearing and the end of the differential itself, save any galling of the shaft. If it did run dry, it would possibly gall and seize in there. Highly unlikely, well, the amount of grease you're going to be pumping in anyway. So these, just when you fit them with the clips on, you just slide them in until they're on the spline and give a good sharp tap, and the wire clip should lock in behind one of the output gears. Same on this side, exactly the same. These have been shimmed up as well. Normally there's a little bit of end float between the spline clip and the gears inside. We want to minimise that because we're using the disc brake, so there's a shim bonded onto the face there that removes the worst of the end float, and with the outer bearing they run fairly true and don't deflect too much. The differential itself has 5 grease points on it, and you just pump a normal general purpose lithium grease into those. Just keep pumping grease in until it appears to be emerging inside the differential. You can't really over grease it. Well, you could. But you just keep pumping grease in it. The sprocket is bolted onto a flange on the differential itself. If you ever need to change the sprocket on these ones, you need to remove the left hand end plate and then jack the bearing carrier off the bearing, and then that will give you clearance to take these 8 bolts out and pull the sprocket off and replace it, and then press the bearing carrier back on the bearing and reassemble. And that's far as weight. See, don't lose the clips. They are available from any Ford dealer. And if you put it on the scales there, it's weighing 16.85 kilograms with the disc brakes, but without the calipers.